The Iranian government started its reign with fear. The new generation does not have any fear. You see young people flipping clerics' turbans. This is not a protest anymore. It's really a women-led revolutionary movement. Men have been screwing up for centuries. It's time for trusting women, and it's time for following women.
In cities across Iran, women are showing displays of defiance against the strict dress code, burning their hijabs while large crowds cheer them on.
People want to change the government, to change the regime.
The first death sentence for a protester.
Three more death sentences to protesters.
The Iranian government has made journalism a crime. We rely on citizen journalists to contribute to us anonymously. People have had enough. There are two main slogans in Iran right now: death to the dictator and woman, life, freedom. My name is Mazyar Bahari. I'm the founder of IranWire.com. IranWire pairs citizen journalists inside the country with professional Iranian journalists in exile all over the world. So professional journalists can mentor citizen journalists inside the country. We have intentionally avoided working with professional journalists because working as a professional journalist in Iran is a dangerous business. They could be arrested at any point, so we rely on citizen journalists. Our mandate is really to make the government accountable for its actions.
Iran's rulers are cracking down hard. Dozens of protesters have been killed, hundreds arrested, and the internet choked off.
Iran has handed down its first death penalty sentence to an anti-government protester.
We've started to count the number of the people who've perished or imprisoned by the regime. And unfortunately, the number is increasing every day.
Anger sweeping across the country following the death of 22-year-old Mahsa Amini,
who died in police custody after being arrested by Iran's so-called morality police for not wearing her headscarf properly.
She was a young woman from a small town who came to Tehran for a couple of days just to visit her family. She was arrested by the morality police because she was showing too much hair, according to them. She was beaten and taken to hospital. She died on September 16th.
They've expanded beyond just protesting the hijab. Many are actually aimed at the supreme leader of Iran.
People are becoming poorer. The government is becoming more corrupt and more dictatorial. So what happened in September, the death of Mahsa Amini, triggered this explosion in Iran. People have been trying to reform the Iranian government for the past 25 years, and they have failed. In the beginning of the protest, 99.99% of people thought that it would last maybe 3 or 4 days. But young people of Iran in general, have surprised us.
We turn now to Iran and a new effort to bring freedom to all the jailed reporters there.
During a series of protests staged in Tehran, the authorities clamped down and made many arrests. Among them was Mazyar Bahari.
Iranian-Canadian journalist Mazyar Bahari was in Tehran covering the election.
I was arrested in 2009 because of my reporting. I spent 118 days in prison, 107 days in solitary confinement. There was no toilet or there was no bed. They gave me 2 blankets. I had to use one of them as my mattress. When I was in prison, my interrogator told me that journalists gather information and sell information, and spies gather information and sell information. So journalists are spies. The more I resisted not to call myself a spy, the more beatings I had, the more psychological torture I had to go through.
They are masters of psychological torture. They know exactly what to do.
What I went through is indicative of what many other journalists are going through. There are more than 50 professional journalists in prison. For example, Niloufar Hamidi, who was a sports journalist, and after Mahsa Amini went to hospital, Niloufar went to the hospital and reported for her newspaper in Iran. And now she's being charged. So people have to know about Niloufar. She cannot just be a number or a name. Security of our citizen journalists is the main priority for us. Whenever they send us a video or an article, we ask them to conceal their identities. We have to get rid of the metadata of photos, videos. We have to anonymize where they are because the Iranian government is very good in terms of adopting new technology and spy technology. Our website is subjected to DDoS attack almost on an hourly basis. We have to be always one step ahead of the Iranian government.
2018, President Trump
pulling the U.S. out of the Iran nuclear deal and imposing tough new sanctions.
There are so many sanctions on Iran.
The Iranian government is supposed to be subjected to sanctions by the United States and the European community, but for whatever reason, it manages to buy weapons from different countries, even members of NATO, for example, Turkey.
The army calling the protesters enemies and threatening to confront them.
The Iranian regime have been using water cannons to fight against the protests. This is a water cannon that was used in southern part of Iran. We realized it was Chinese company making these types of water cannon. And then we had to look at the database of that Chinese company to find out that this is a type of water cannon that imported from China in Iran.
The Iranian regime has shut down the internet.
A near total internet blackout.
The internet is completely down.
The Iranian regime has made information the enemy,
cutting many of its people off from the outside world.
The Iranian regime is also very good in terms of adopting new technology in order to infiltrate citizens' phones, phishing methods. It's very normal in Iran for the police to stop you, search your phone. As soon as a citizen journalist send us the report, we ask them to delete it. People have asked me how many human rights violations the Iranian government has committed. And it's very difficult for me to count the violations that it has not committed. Arbitrary arrests, torture, kidnapping, illegal arrests, extrajudicial executions, illegal imprisonment, forced confessions. And right now, because the government is really worried about its survival, it is committing all those atrocities at the same time.